Hi guys, it's Lynn here. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Now guys, this is just a quick video to let you know what to look for signs of cold damage on your cacti and succulent plants at this time of year. Now, as you know, me and Hansi, we have a polytunnel here that we keep at a minimum of about 5 degrees Celsius, which is about 43 degrees Fahrenheit. And it usually stays at around the 7 to 8 Celsius mark, which is about 45 to about 47 degree Fahrenheit. So the plants are good, and we have all the ones that are quite cold hardy in here. And as I say, we keep the majority of them dry. So far, so good. They've been 3.5 months in here and it's brilliant. But this is the first one we've come across that we have noticed is showing signs of suffering a little bit. Now this particular plant here, it's actually, we think it's a trichocereus variety. We're not 100% sure, but as you can see here, it has got some signs of little orange, like tiny rust marks. Now this is caused usually by two things, and I think this is the two things that's caused this. One is the temperatures are colder than ideal for this plant, and it will form stress marks as in little tiny brown little spots on here, and also high humidity levels. And I'll just show you here, this is our hydrometer that tells you the humidity. Now it's on just over 80% humidity, so it is high, but it's usually higher than that in here, guys. We've had it over 100, about 110% on very wet days, even though we've got the heater running at the moment, which helps to dry the humidity out. So that's actually good for us to have the humidity that dry, believe it or not, guys. But it's still obviously growing cacti, so it's not ideal. And the cooler temperatures does cause this, that does happen on these plants. Now, we have a few trichocereus varieties, and these are very, very hardy, don't seem to have a problem with the humidity or the coldness. But this plant is Hansi's, and he's had that before growing in his apartment in Sweden, where it's used to having very dry air indoors and obviously a lot warmer temperature. So this is the first winter it's been overwintered in Ireland out here, and that's possibly what's caused this. As I say, these plants are very tolerant of cold temperatures, and I see the soil is dry, so we haven't watered any of these. But this is actually harmless. It's just more aesthetic. It just causes a bit of an orange scabbing on the outside there. And it's usually caused from a combination of both the humidity being higher than ideal and the cold temperatures. As I say, you don't really tend to see this in the summer. But it can also be caused as well when you spray plants with pesticides. Sometimes this orange spotting can come up. And as you see the top, there's a black at the growing tip. Also signs of being too cold and damp. So this plant is going to be coming in the house, and it's going to be overwintered indoors in our plant room or in the kitchen with all the other plants that aren't as cold hardy to be out here. And so no harm will come to this. It will outgrow the damage, but it's something to look for. It's clearly saying that this plant is not happy out here. It wants to be drier air and a warmer temperature. As I say, we're not 100% sure of this type of plant. So if you know, please let us know, guys. We assume it's a trichocereus, but as I say, there's so many different hybrids, and different trichocereus can cope with different type of temperatures. They're usually very cold hardy, so I think it's more the humidity and the cold that's done this. Now, I've made a video already on black spots and pustules on trichocereus and pilosocereus cacti. Links up above to that, because this is a common thing that these plants do seem to have, the slightest bit of humidity, or if you spray them with any type of bug sprays and things like that, they don't like it, and it can react on the skin, and it is a common thing, and it does eventually outgrow the damage. As you can see, there's little black spots there also, and we have these on a lot of our trichocereus cacti, as you can see there. And I have to say, I think it's more of a problem in northern hemispheres because of the humidity. If these were grown in a drier climate like Arizona, you probably wouldn't be getting this. As I say, it's more aesthetic. It doesn't seem to really be a problem. It doesn't seem to kill the plant or anything like that, but it's not the most attractive. And I'm pretty convinced it is down to the damp. Look at that there, guys. That was actually done last summer. And it always seems to happen after a very bad spell of damp, as the summer was damp last year also, and that seemed to happen after that. But new growth, it always outgrows the damage. But as I say, this time of year, when it comes to overwintering your plants, it's just to keep an eye on them, because when they're not actively growing, and do you know, in Ireland, it's not the most sunniest of climates. we are sort of blessed with mild winters, and it has been pretty good here the past few days. As you can see, the sun is coming through, and the polytunnel gets plenty of sun and light in here. And it's just a case of monitoring the plants and bringing in any that aren't doing as good. So this one's going to be going back inside the house, and it should make a complete recovery. So guys, just hope that helps you out if you spot this on your plants and you're growing them outdoors or indoors. This sometimes happens in plants that are in windowsills where there's drafts, and it doesn't matter how warm the house is. If the draft is coming through, this often happens too. So just to say, don't panic. It will outgrow. This will eventually fade. And it's just the plants letting you know that it's not happy, and it's best to increase the temperature and the air if possible. Air humidity. So not the air humidity to be a lot drier. So too much humidity and cold is not good for cacti. So guys, I want to send you loads of love, heaps of happiness, and tons of plant power. As always, from Ireland. Until the next video, guys. Bye.